Grace, peace, and mercy be unto you from God our Father and Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Pastor Emmanuel Nahum. To my left,
Minister Renee Jr.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Welcome everybody, like, subscribe to Life in the Word. We've been continuing, remaining steady on a steady world. Happy, Thursday we're in?
Happy Thursday.
So, 2 Timothy 3, verse 10. Keep the message alive. You've been a good apprentice to me. So, you know, this whole thing is about Paul talking to his spiritual son, Timothy. So he's telling him how the last day, because the last days, like I said, did not start now. Mm-hmm. Now is not the last. The last day started back 2,000 years ago. Mm-hmm. So he's talking to him about the last days, which the beginning of the last day. This is the end of the ending of the last days. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Now, he said, you've been a good apprentice to me, a part of my teaching, my manner of life, direction, faith, steadiness, love, patience, trouble, suffering along with me, and all the grief I had to put up with in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra. So now, it's a spiritual father talking to a spiritual son. Mm-hmm. And if I look at it, man, this guy suffered. Mm-hmm. It's not as you look at it as pastors these days, wearing nice shoes and people carrying bags. And it's, man, people trying to kill him. People trying to destroy his life. And Paul was not, you know, thing to say, hey, I struggled. I suffered.
Yeah.
Everywhere I go as a preacher, people were trying to kill me.
Yes.
People were trying to destroy me. You understand that kind of religion, right, that we preach right now is opposed to the true religion of Christ. Because the minute people begin to suffer, man, they feel like God don't love me, God don't care about me. Mm-hmm. But when I look at the Bible, man, and I look at these men of God, mm-hmm. Christian was being killed. Mm-hmm. Christian was being thrown to lions.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You understand? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Christian was being a pastor, man, your life is at stake.
Every day.
Yeah. Every day. Every minute. Mm-hmm. They're going to throw you to lions. And I think that not teaching the message, the true message of God, message of God, keep us from having authentic Christians who understand when you come to Christ, you are to embrace suffering. God, you are to embrace pain and hurt, because when Jesus, who is your Lord and Savior, his whole ministry is about dying and killing and destroying. But there is a religion that speak of nothing but good. Nothing but good. But when I read this Bible, it says you're going to suffer. Jesus said in the book of Matthew, he said, in this world, you're going to have trouble. But he said, believe in me. As you believe in God, believe in me. So, that's going to create a different kind of Christian in these last days. Because that's what it's going to... I do believe most of the church is not actually saved. I believe they're not saved.
Yes.
Wow.
I believe that people come to church and they sing, they dance, they even preach and pastors. But true Christianity, it is the attempt to live like him. True Christianity have to do with a transformation of life.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. If there is no transformation, there is no life of God. If there's nothing in you that's changing. No. I think I put something up today. If I'm living like my next door neighbor, and I say I'm saved, how saved can I be? If I'm doing the same thing that my next door neighbor is doing, I'm not saved. Because we teach Christians, confession is enough. It's like saying, well, I do, but I'm going to be acting like a single man though. You go to the woman, you take this one to be a, yeah, yeah, I do. But I ain't gonna decide to be living like a husband. I'm still gonna live single though, but I do. I just, so what, then why you marry? I just wanna make sure I got me a piece at home. If I don't get nothing out there, at least I got this. You know, no life change. Marriage demands a behavior change.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Hello. Marriage demands forsaking all others. Yeah. That means mother, father, friend. You have no side guy, no side man. Mm-hmm. Nobody else is more important than the person you said I do to. Mm-hmm. See that, right? Mm-hmm. Marriage demands a transformation of life. Amen.
Amen.
It demands that for the rest of your life. This is why I talk about marriage alignment, because it's the same alignment of the person who created it. It is a covenant. It is a commitment to only one person for the rest of your life, till death do you part. Mm-hmm. See that, right? Mm-hmm. When you come to Jesus, Jesus demands all interaction with Satan to stop, and his environment, and what he wants, and what he likes, anything he's connected to, you are to divorce yourself from that and align with him. And everything that he does, everything he believes, and everything, he's the only one. He is supreme in your thoughts, in your mind, in your soul, in your spirit. He does not try to compromise with that. He said, I want all of you. I want every piece of you. Because guess what he says? The Lord your God is a jealous God. So he don't want you to interact with nobody else. He don't want you to love nobody else. He don't want you to be with nobody else. He don't even want you to think about nobody else. He don't want you to give your body to nobody else. He said, you belong to me absolutely, Jesus, in every single way possible, in every hour, in every second, every minute. You belong to me. And let me tell you something, that's his right. That's his right. Why is it that's his right? Because he paid the price for him to say that. When your husband says, I'm the only man you have to think of, there should be no other man in your heart. There should be no other man you think about. You understand that? I remember one guy said today, a woman doesn't need a man, right, to make her a wife. Because God already called her a wife.
That's good.
But you need a woman to become a husband. See, I want you to think about it. Okay. That's what you think about. God already called her wife. That's why he said, he who finds what?
A wife.
See? God already called her a wife. You don't make her a wife when you marry her. Because then when he said, he who finds a wife. So you're not a wife after marriage. You're a wife way before marriage. It's for all the singles, because you're still trying to be whatever. But if maybe you don't got no man, because you were not a wife. You're not a wife because the pastor made you wife. You're a wife because God made you one.
Yes.
And if you're a wife, you don't go giving your body to anybody else. Because you, see, the thing is that all your life, you've been waiting for your for that husband to find you. Because you make him a husband. But he don't make you a wife. God does. God the lady. Just think about this. He's out here being a false prophet, saying stuff that in the scriptures. It's in the book of Genesis, in the book of Proverbs, that God already called you a wife way before you married. He don't make you a wife, but you make him a husband. Amen. So God wants what? All of you. He wants every piece of you. He wants every part of you. He wants every single thing concerning you. Because in this last days, There have to be a difference between you and them.
Yes.
There have to be a difference between the sheep and the goats. Nobody hear me?
Mm-hmm.
And the difference is becoming clear. Because let me tell you what the goats are doing. They're letting you know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
Satan is letting you know who he is. Mm-hmm. And every piece of society and movies and music and industry and fashion,
mm-hmm.
Satan is saying, I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
What are you saying?
Mm-hmm.
They're not apologizing for who they are. Mm-hmm. Do you know that some Christians hide who they are in certain aspect of life?
Mm-hmm.
They still hide their true identity of Christ because they want to fit in.
Mm-hmm.
But this world is telling you, I don't want to fit in. This is who I am. You fit into my world.
Mm-hmm.
You accept me. You do me. Mm-hmm. This is my world. And you're going to have to accept me. Mm-hmm. But the Christian is busy trying to hide in the church and not fully. And when do you, let me tell you something. I have to say I respect all aspect of life. One thing I know about, you know, when a guy come out,
mm-hmm.
he may try to fake it
mm-hmm.
a little bit before he comes out.
Mm-hmm.
You know that, right? Because I had some friends try to fake it before he comes out, still trying to be manly because mm-hmm. he don't want, you know, you can see that air, the flamboyancy, mm-hmm. but he doesn't fully come out. But the minute he said, I'm out, lipsticks, wigs, everything is out, because he said, I'm all the way in. But we have Christian who's halfway living. But when you end God fully, I'm all the way in. There's no evidence that you won't guess whose part I'm in and who I belong to. This is what Satan's doing. What we Christians doing. Playing defense. Still trying to play both. But I believe it's time to come out. Fully out.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We're going to stop right here.
Yeah, good.
My name is Pastor Emmanuel, and I have to my left.
My name is Renee Jr.
We have one thing to say.
Jesus
is Lord. God bless.